All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Jack Stoch. He's the CEO of Globex Mining. And Jack, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Thank you very much. This is starting to become a habit.
Yes. Well, you've got lots of news out with some of the companies in your portfolios. We talked about in the past, you have a very large portfolio. And this one specifically relates to the Eagle Mine. So maybe you can sort of tell us a little bit about this one and how the company Maple Gold Mine fits into it.
Globex over a number of years has put together a package which covers most of the Joutel mining camp. And Maple approached us to acquire the Eagle Mine, which used to belong to Agnico Eagle. So we negotiated a deal with cash payments about $1.2 million over 5 years and a minimum of $1.2 million in work over 4 years, with Globex retaining a 2.5% gross metal royalty. The Eagle Mine, combined with Telbel, which are actually one deposit, was mined for over 6 million tons of over 6 grams gold. So there was a small resource when we picked up the property. We did a bit of work on it, Maple optioned it, and they've started a drill campaign. They've completed phase one, which was 8 holes. Today they announced the second 4 holes, and they got some pretty decent results, up to 7.5 meters of 4 grams gold. The thing that's really interesting is that they're getting different styles of mineralization than the original Eagle-Telbel mineralization, plus the zones that are parallel to the main ore body horizon. So it's looking very, very good. And this is all part of a larger package, including a number of former producers, plus a very large package that we optioned to Orford, who also announced it positive drill results about 2 weeks ago.
Jack, maybe you could talk about that. When you say different style of mineralization, can you talk a bit more about that?
Well, there's the main horizon, which is a sort of semi-massive pyrite in iron carbonate. And now they're getting mineralization in quartz carbonate veinlets, sometimes with visible gold, as well as in the marker horizon on the northeast of the mine horizon. There's a marker horizon, which is pyritic graphite. And they're actually getting gold values in that too, up to 2.4 grams over 4.7 meters. So this opens up a whole new potential in an area that really wasn't looked at before.
Okay. Jack, I wanted to ask you lastly, you know, this is obviously good results here, which is very, very important, but you know, we've seen the troubles in the market in the last couple of months, especially when it comes to, you know, some of the mining stocks. I'm just wondering how your company is faring through this, because is it easier when you have the amount of projects and royalties that you are dealing with? Is it easier to weather a storm like this?
Well, it's never easy. We're getting some pressure also on the stock price and the number of buyers out there with available cash to pay for purchases is reduced, and they bargain a bit harder than they normally would in a crazy market that people want to put money into almost anything. But on the other side of the equation, land is going to become available, and we're up to about 212 projects, including royalties. So we're still acquiring more ground. So, you know, it's half a dozen of one, six of the other, really.
Yeah, it's a busy time for sure. Well, Jack, I appreciate you updating us on what's going on with Eagle Mine, and we'll, of course, keep an update on everything else that's going on with Globex. So appreciate your time.
Great. Thank you very much for your time.
All right. There's Jack Stoch, the CEO of Globex Mining.